this animation, we will discuss antibodies, reviewing what they are, what their function is, and how researchers have turned them into scientific tools. Antibodies are proteins that are produced by the immune system to combat pathogens. Structurally, we can break them down into a constant region called FC and a variable region called FV. The constant region is the same for every antibody in your body. The variable region is different for each antibody and represents a binding site specific for one particular antigen. Antigens are displayed on everything, from a transplanted organ to a foreign microbe. And these antigens cause the production of their specific antibody. Evolution has conferred great genetic diversity for the variable region, allowing the immune system to recognize over 10 billion different antigens. Clearly, antibodies recognize a wide variety of targets. But you may be wondering, how are they made? Antibodies are produced by B cells. B cells circulate throughout the body, waiting to find the antigen to which their specific antibody binds. If the B cell finds that antigen in the presence of other danger signals from the body, it produces thousands of antibodies in response. These antibodies then enter circulation, neutralizing the antigen wherever it is encountered. Now let's consider how antibodies assist our immune cells in removing dangerous invaders. Antibodies mark their antigen for attack, but how are these attacks carried out? Macrophages, which have receptors for the FC portion of an antibody, will bind the antibody, engulf the whole target, and digest it with internal chemicals and enzymes. Natural killer cells bind to antibodies and secrete chemicals that cause the target to lyse. These are just two of the many ways which antibodies can be used by the immune system to remove invaders from circulation. Today, scientists have adapted antibodies as powerful research tools that can be used in procedures such as Western blotting. Western blotting is a popular technique used to identify protein expression in cells. First, researchers lyse the cells and run that lysate on a protein gel. The proteins are then transferred to a membrane with high affinity for proteins. Now, let's say that we have a desired protein for which we want to study the expression. Once the proteins are on the membrane, we add a primary antibody, one that binds specifically to our protein of interest. Then, we add a secondary antibody, which binds to the primary antibody. This secondary antibody is conjugated to a fluorescent probe. Using one of a variety of methods, we can detect the amount of light produced. More light means more antibodies were bound, signifying more protein was present.